show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com. This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. Production services by Sidekick Media Services. And listeners like you, supporting us at patreon.com/awesomecast. It's time to get geeky, get awesome. It is the Awesome Cast. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the social medias here in the Sorgatron Media Studio in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And we're going to get geeky tonight. First of all, from Studio Duds, it is the Dudders.
From Studio Duds, it is someone completely different. It's funny.
Katie Dudders.
There you go. You know, that would be fun if we just did a thing where we all just went to each other's house. And who gets to sit here and push all the buttons, though, right?
You didn't do yours. You know, you have to do Mike Sorg.
It feels weird to introduce myself with my own music.
It's Mike Sorg.
Yes. And that voice, that sexy voice you've been hearing the last few weeks as I figure out how these buttons work. Wait, hold on. I can't find a button for them.
Oh.
I'll get it here in a second. Where'd it go?
It's all right. You just added it.
Hey!
Hey!
Kid Mental is with us.
So messed up.
And it gets his shot. He's like, I got to fix my stuff.
Yeah,
I got to fix my stuff.
Because Mike's not going to tell me.
Did you see all the technology problems that we're having before the show? Yeah, we were a little late today because we're not that late. Oh, I guess we are pretty late. It's about quarter after. No, there was something going on with Restream. So Twitch is not getting us this evening and YouTube almost didn't. But we are here. We are out there. We are ready. I'm going to remember to share everything. We're on hello, everybody on the Facebook as well. We'll make sure everybody knows that we're live. So it's going to be one of those kinds of nights, apparently. Let's get into our awesome things of the week. Who wants to go first?
Yeah.
Who wants to go first? Katie. Actually, Katie. Katie's got the good news of the day, actually.
Oh.
Yay. That means you got the bad news.
No.
You got the
good community news of the week. So let's start with that.
Ah, excellent. Today is a big day if you're working for a nonprofit or if you love a nonprofit. It is Giving Tuesday. And one particular nonprofit that I am quite fond of is 412 Thrive. And we go through Give Big Pittsburgh, which is the Pittsburgh Magazine's kind of initiative, and they kind of host all of that and all the donations. And I forget how many local charity and organizations use that platform, but it's a lot. But I'm fundraising today for 412 Thrive. It's one of my cancer groups that I belong to, and we have some of the most fun. They also do an amazing thing called, they give out these care packages. If you're going through like chemo, radiation, or mastectomy, and their care packages, include a shower chair, which was game changing when I was going through things. So that's, mm-hmm. they'll always be number one in my book for that. But yeah, so it's definitely a group that I'm very passionate about. I do some work with them social media wise, IT wise too, which is my way of giving back and, you know, helping somebody else who's kind of just maybe starting out or, you know, into this whole cancer BS world. And this is my way to, you know, kind of give back and find silver lining and things. But yeah,
absolutely.
So if you're looking to someone to donate for, 412 Thrive. I even have my cup today. Ooh.
Represent all over. Nice.
Yes.
Yeah, no, I love it. You know, Christopher Whitlatch has done a lot of work with Giving Tuesday for organizations over the years too. So, you know, that's what, you know, what is it? It's a Black Friday, it's Cyber Monday, Small Business Saturday, and then the Giving Tuesday and the 1, 2, 3, 4 punch there, I guess, after Thanksgiving, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sunday, just go to church, guys. apparently. That's great. So it's givepittsburgh.com/organization/412thrive if you want to drop in there. Is it because I know a lot of people are going to listen to this on the feed in the morning. Does that extend? Is it Tuesday only? Is there the window for this, or is it a little kind of stretched out there?
It's Tuesday only, but okay. You can always check out 412thrive.org. see what we're doing, and you could donate that way too, because we accept donations year round.
That's right.
Or it takes a lot of money to support.
Or at least follow them so that you don't miss next year's Giving Tuesday.
Yeah.
Right?
There you go. Yes.
Whatever rolls that around. So, Kid Mental,
what
is your awesome thing of the week? I know we both put two in, so we'll do a secondary awesome after the first break.
Oh yeah,
yeah. Let's go ahead. We'll go with it.
Yeah, like okay. So look at that. See, now I got nothing. It's like the pepperoni is up. Anyway. Yo,
we have some pizza faux pas here.
Yeah,
before the show, I forgot my Kid Mental note on the pizza order.
Oh,
so,
oh my goodness! And I texted you. I was like, "No hog, no smog, bring in the kids."
Oh, that's what that means.
And he was like, "What?"
I did not decipher the code.
Oh, oh man,
I thought you were just being clever.
Wow.
It's been a day. I'm lucky. I'm
you're gonna call
right
it a
now.
Day now.
I'm lucky. I'm upright right now.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's put it
true.
That way.
What was that? Oh,
gosh.
Teenage Engineering, yo. Mm-hmm. The new KO2. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm trying to get that. I have a circuit rhythm, which I think it's maybe I've never touched it. But I want to trade that in and get this KO2. The KO2, did you pull up the website? I don't know. But
which one is it?
The second one, I think.
There you go.
It's okay. Yo, this thing is, it's only $300. So like, if you guys are watching Kid Mental here, yeah, you know I mean, as for the wish list, yeah, you know I'm saying like, but I have the KO, I have the first KO, mm-hmm. And it's just a small pocket operator. It fits in your pocket. I think it's in my truck right now.
Mm-hmm.
But you can sample on it. It fits in your hand. And you can do, it's really powerful and you can do this. But this one is just it looks really fun. Like you can do extra. So you got the A, B, C, and D. So you don't have to just stick to one. You can switch. You have four different levels right there. So
mm-hmm.
I could set a beat on A, and then on B, I can go through and put samples on B, and then on C, I can, you know, add a different sound and the same thing. So you have a little bit more leeway on this one. You can chop it up. They usually have these little special effects for different pads too. So I'm pretty sure you can do all of that stuff. So, I mean, their stuff is usually expensive and this one seems like really reasonable to have.
$299, yeah.
Yeah. And it does, I mean, it seems like I don't know. I already fell in love with it because I had the KO1.
Mm-hmm. You talked about last time you were on the show, you talked about like, we talked about if people want to get into the sampling and everything, like what you're doing,
uh-huh.
like, you know, starting with apps and things like that. Is this a good next step up from like the iPhone, iPad app situation? Do you think this is a good starter for a lot of people, or is there like an in-between people should be using?
Depends on the level of money you have, I guess, but like, it from the koala, like literally the koala app does all of the stuff that you've seen there, mm-hmm. plus more, because you have a little bit more leeway because it's not a hardware where you're stuck to the specific specifications. But I mean that thing right there, the koala, you can practically do it. I mean, if you want to go to hardware though, the next step up before the KO2 would be the KO1.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely, it's probably about $100 anyway. So like, you know, if you don't have the $200, you could probably. They used to be like 89 something. Now, I guess they're just going up on prices. Either maybe they're not making them anymore, or what. But like, it went up pretty substantially,
because
mm-hmm. the bass one that I had, which is not a sampler. Bass one is just bass synths plus drums. Each pocket operator gets drums, and then you get like 16, then you get 15 other synths with it, and then you can chain and link and go through it. So if you're used to Koala and chaining on there, learning to chain on a pocket operator is not going to be that hard. And then if you pick up a keyboard or anything else, you'll have that knowledge to do that too. So the pocket operators definitely like my, the base one that I had, I think it was like 49, and I think they're still selling it now at 89 and 99. It boosted up in price like crazy. So
I still, it's not, it doesn't seem obscenely prohibitive, right?
No.
Like I look at when I'm doing sound, like if I'm thinking from a podcaster mindset, like you can get going pretty decent podcasting with about like a $200 Zoom device and you know, $100 microphones if you're good, right?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
that seems like that's kind of in that kind of pocket,
yeah.
Right? Like, well, it's some serious money, but it's not like
it's not
the,
crazy.
Out
it's
of
not
the
like
range, a, if I really want
to
do,
yeah,
this.
Yeah, it's not know? Like 800 to 1,000,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah. So I keep miss switching and getting Katie on the shot, just looking at her that's phone.
Good. Yeah, I love those shots. Those are the best shots.
Just me. I was like, oh, I was getting a bunch of messages, and I was like, what's happening?
That's me. I was blowing your phone up.
There you go. There
Thanks.
You go. No, that's cool. So that is the, oh, I lost the tab here.
That is the Teenage Engineering KO2. It just came out, I think last week. Pretty sure.
There you go. Brand new. Go
brand
get it.
Spanking new. Get it for Christmas.
There you go.
For
there
kid,
you go.
Kid Mental's under his Christmas tree.
What's up, Santa? What's up? my awesome thing of the week is something, it's kind of an oldie but a goodie, because we talk about, like, I've had a lot of things that have been on the fringe that I know I should pay more attention to for productivity tools that we've talked about over the year, whether I know this is a tool that I'm sure Chilla's brought up over the year, but I'm very, you know, along with the AI conversation we've been having about how to streamline things for content development and social media and making videos and things like that. In that vein, I started, and plus the fact that social media is now like imploding on itself these days, and I'm trying to figure out how to properly make sure I'm still in a lot of places. So between that mission and the Wellatory app that I've talked about a bit ago, having ties into apps for checking your wellness and well-being, and also checks your social media usage along with that to try to make determinations. If this, then that, ifttt.com, if you want to check it out, was really needed to connect a lot of those apps. So I finally bit the bullet, signed up for Pro Plus, and now that opened things up, and now I'm starting to apply it in the last week over my social media. What does that mean? It means, one of the things that we started putting in was, hey, okay, we scheduled a bunch of YouTube videos, but we don't follow up and put like tweets out about the videos that we put on YouTube, right? And we're putting a lot of content out on our like indiewrestling.us YouTube. Plus we're doing, you know, shorts and other bits for like Wrestling Mayhem show and this show. So I wanted kind of like a holistic approach. So one of the things I did was every time now that a video publishes on YouTube, it's going to run a script and turn that into a tweet and get that out there. It's not tagged. It's not anything like that, but at least it's in your feed, right? It's kind of a bare minimum. Plus, it's Twitter. I'm sure they don't like links out right now. But still, it gets into that system. And I'm looking into, okay, how does this apply? I'm looking forward to when that applies to, you know, hopefully Mastodon and Threads and what's the other one? Blue Sky. By the way, Blue Sky finally sent me my code that I asked for when you set up for the mailing list. So I have yet another invite code if somebody wants one.
What is Blue Sky?
We'll get to that after the break. that's a whole section of the story. But so the kind of way, you know, and I've had a few in here. Like I've actually had one in here for the longest time where I get an email every day that's a picture from NASA. It could be something like, you know, looking down on the planet, or them, you know, astronauts training or something like that. It's a lot of fun stuff. So like that's been like my little bit of usage going on there. So I already set it up for one of my accounts to tweet Happy New Year was one of them. You know, and they're pretty simple. But once you get into this, there's some Trello threads in here I'm starting to look at.
What the crap is this?
So this is it.
Like I've had this on my phone for like the longest and I've never.
It's if this then that, right? So the idea is like, you know.
Oh, that's what the TT stands for.
Yes.
If Are this, you kidding
that.
Me?
Nope.
This whole time I thought it was just T-T-T-T-T.
You just thought you thought it was just like a weird
Yeah. I was like, I've seen this before, and I'm like, yo, like I got the app. Mm-hmm. I've just never used it because I was like, why do I have this?
So like they have some in here, like they have ones that are already made, but you can go and say, hey, I want when this app does this, like, look for my Twitter to do this, or like,
if so it's constantly monitoring.
It's constantly, well, at least like periodically. Hey, is there anything new on Twitter or Instagram?
Uh-huh.
And then you trigger, hey, take that Instagram and make it into a post with a picture on Twitter if you want those to sync up.
It has to be Twitter though.
Well, there's a lot of, okay, hold on. Let me get into services here.
Oh,
there's a lot you can do here. Okay. So like, that's it. Get weather forecast every day at 7 a.m.
Well, where is it going?
Where, in this case, it sends it to a notification.
It's
to
not
your
even
phone.
Connected. It says connected.
No. These are just samples. These are samples. I haven't hooked them up yet.
Okay.
Text your lost Android phone to turn the ringer volume up to 100%. You can set up. Get a morning reminder about your first meeting daily. You connect your calendar to your Slack channel to do something like that. Automatically create a Discover Weekly archive over on Spotify.
Is there a way to like remove Alexa from telling, notifying me about sports?
No, I think you need to go into Alexa to
no,
do that.
It won't work.
I know. No. This is not a subtractive thing. This is an additive service.
So it's all, everything's additive.
Now, if you want something to happen and it talks to you, like some people use, like, you know, I'm pretty sure you can take your like Ring doorbell and, hey, when somebody arrives, it turns the thermostat on. Like you can connect those kinds of things.
Like that's,
If you're into home automation, this is a thing to look at.
You're lying.
This is one of those
dude,
things.
Dude, I'm
so the possibilities are blowing your mind, but it takes a bit to kind of sink into it and say, okay, this is what we need to do to kind of connect things. And as far as like, I can connect it to like, my room is not like terribly smart. I've seen it try to move. but you could do something like, you know, hey, people are away. Don't run the Roomba unless there's nobody in the house. Right?
I mean, I already like, do that. Yeah. I already do that stuff with the Alexa's what is it called with the R routines.
Yeah.
Like I got all these mad routines like just set up already.
So ideally, if you want to connect something that maybe you know, Amazon or one of the other
Arlo, okay.
There's some high-end stuff in here that you and I are never going to touch.
That's what I want to see. I want to see a high-end stuff so I could try to touch it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, there's a lot.
If it's all additive, I could be like, yo, tap into Jeff Bezos' bank account and add stuff to my account, right?
I don't think they have any banking in here necessarily.
Well,
but,
they're going to have it now. So I'm about to...
But you see, like, there's D-Link Wi-Fi routers. There's like, I saw City of Tampa and was in here. Discord servers, Dropbox, like every time, like what if every time you drop something new to Dropbox in a certain folder, it tweets it out.
Yo!
Now he's in.
Well, what are you talking about? I've been trying.
Now he's all in.
Well, yeah, I'm saying I could, dude.
Like here, receive a text when there's a new shared file link to the Dropbox, send or receive an SMS when there's a new shared file on Dropbox, things like that. So, like, it's really powerful if you have very, you know, to do very specific things that will hopefully help you. Like, hey, I keep forgetting to do X. There's ones in here, and there's ties to AI that we've been talking about here lately.
Where's the AI at,
you can let me see if I can plug some AI stuff in here.
Oh.
So here, tagged emails generate an AI response. Oh. AI generated tweets from your blog posts. Oh. Yeah. And generate LinkedIn updates for your blog posts.
Ethical AI FB posters. So there's a non-ethical one?
Oh, the ethical AI is a whole thing.
I want a non-ethical
that's another there's a whole podcast for that. So there's a lot of, like, here you want just a weekly email of AI related stories from TechCrunch. There's ones that'll give you like a blog starter, new feed item from RSS, then craft an AI post to Twitter.
so you can have
it look at your RSS feed, and if you post a new post, you know, blog, something like that, so that would read that, look at what's in the RSS, and then make a post on Twitter using AI automatically.
Why is everything Twitter though?
Well, that's one of the services.
This is like, you just keep saying twit.
Because that's...
I ain't even Twitter no more. It's called X.
I feel like they have X, but they still say Twitter in most cases.
They only say that because they got a whole bunch of morons out there that don't understand what's going on. That's the only reason.
But also, like, I'm looking for X on a... You search for X.
X is really hard to find.
Yeah.
You're going to find things
there's
that you
a
don't
problem.
Want.
So until we
a lot of things you don't
until
want.
Until we solve that problem.
How about we don't? How about we just turn it back to Twitter. Like, why?
I think it's a silent, a silent revolt.
Why doesn't he just call it underscore X? Because I understand, it's because of SpaceX, right? So it's X, SpaceX.
I don't think it's even that. It's from before all that.
You think it's before that?
The story is that PayPal was supposed to be part of the Everything app with X.com. Like, this is an old idea that he's able to bring back. But I don't want to.
Well, that's where SpaceX came from, though.
But I don't want to talk.
It's just X. Everything's X.
X is just cool, right?
No, it's not. It's freaking annoying.
Well, some guy with a lot of money thinks it is. So, anyways.
He needs to be in this room. right now.
So there's a lot of possibilities here. Go check this out.
If this, then that.
If this, then that. If ifttt.com. It's a triple T. So, and there's a lot of fun you can do with that. So,
dude, you didn't use the AwesomeCast drop either. See,
I'm working
too.
On it.
You gotta like, you gotta put your cues.
And those were our
eating in the week.
I muted because one of the videos was playing. Unfortunately, everything goes through the same computer, so I need to manage the sound there. Oh geez,
you're watching another video while we're watching.
No,
while
no, no!
We're
I was
doing,
bringing up her video.
Doing like multiple
was,
things at
yeah,
once.
I'm, well,
that's
I'm bringing
crazy.
Up her video
you're
on the
awesome.
Screen. So, well,
that's why it's an awesome.
I'm feeling
cast.
Less than awesome because this podcast had no sound on the stream for the first 5 minutes. You're not going to notice if you watch this.
We still
later.
Love you. It's okay.
So I'm going to have to fix that when we're done here. Anyways, hey, thanks to our Patreon supporters, patreon.com/awesomecast that has been supporting the show. We try to give a little bit extra content after the show and everything. You can go check it out there. Thank you to our people who are supporting the show at the Coffee Club level, Cynthia Klosky, and at the Fan of the Show level, Michael Fedor, Matt Weller, John Diggy DeGore back again, and Dave Prodner, spouse of Bruce Jewelry Affair at sprucejewelryaffair.com. You guys can have us plug something like that as well if you guys join up and give a buck or more over at patreon.com/awesomecast. We appreciate everybody that does support the show, helps us pay for our podcasty bills and everything like that to keep the show rolling. So go check out, again, patreon.com/awesomecast. So we have some secondary awesome things of the week here that we both put in because we couldn't decide. So tell me about Sketchbook Pro.
Sketchbook Pro, baby. Actually, I bought this maybe a few years ago, and I think it was an Autodesk. It was an Autodesk project or something. Maybe Autodesk bought it, and then I guess they bought their stuff back from them or something. It's no longer Autodesk. So what I bought is no longer available for me. I have to rebuy this. But it was like it's only like $20 on like the Microsoft site. And like, yo, like I don't have to have Photoshop. I don't have to, like, I can draw right onto my tablet and not have any like my handprint on there or anything. Mm-hmm. But the cool thing about this was I got it for my Microsoft Surface, and because I just wanted to draw and I wanted something that I could work with and not have to be like, it's intuitive to, you know, a touchscreen tablet. So I like that. But it also has like the non-app version is a less, like, you see how this one's like condensed in some way.
Yeah, this is like the Mac OS desktop version. So,
okay, so the desktop version, you see you got a lot more more tools and stuff. Well, the other one, it's consolidated, more concise, and you can just like click on a hockey puck, one of the pucks, and change your colors and switch it up or whatever. But the cool thing that I love about this is, I'm not sure if it's available still in the desktop version, but the Steckler version that I kept it to myself and I put it to the side so I can always have it. It has a flip book in it. So I can animate like three layers of animation or two layers of animation, one background. And just like being an artist and not having like the money to buy like Toon Boom, which is, you know, what, $70 a month or something like that. Like to be able to do that, like, it's great. I love the fact that I can just animate something really quick on there and do some test runs or actually get a decent GIF file. I go to like Instagram/SketchJones, I had a couple of loops in there. But it's, you know, I love the fact that I can animate on this desktop version, and because there's not a lot of places that are very intuitive that you can like animate like that without costing you an arm and a leg. So for a quick $20, I think it was, what is that? Is
so,
that
the app? So this is the app version on the iPhone.
So that's like $2.
Download, yeah, it's like $2 for that. You can actually download for free and try it out. So that gets you started with it, right?
Yeah.
And then you can see, like, you know, we talked about this more collapsed kind of, you know, situation.
You see that
here.
Top.
But also, like, if you have like a nice sized iPhone or Android, you can probably get a lot done. Yeah. That's right.
So. You see that top right next to the right? That's the layers. Not that one. The mm-hmm. one next to it.
So the Photoshop type layers you can do. So
don't say Photoshop layers. We've always been doing layers before Photoshop. Photoshop is not the layer people. They're just a-holes that want to take all your money. And they're not. And that's the thing. Like, Sketchbook's not trying to take all your money.
Mm-hmm.
They gave you a tool and it works. And if you go to the website, you could download free extra paint brushes. You could get different paint brushes from the website. You could... I think you can edit yours too, and yeah, I mean, for a cheap, it's cheap. It was like $2 for the app. You could get the $2 for the app. Wow, I didn't even know
that's really cool.
The app was like $2. Yep. It used to be free though. That was crazy because Autodesk gave you the app for free, and then you know I paid for the other one so I could get the flipbook. I'm just worried that the flipbook's not still available since it's not Autodesk anymore. I don't know.
Yeah, I haven't seen anything about that in here yet since I've been plugging with
it. It's only on the desktop version that I know of.
Yep.
So
that's cool. So that you can get started with that mobile version, or if you have an iPad, it probably makes a lot of sense too.
Yes.
Let me double check. Is that also an iPad app too?
Yeah. iPad,
like,
iPad.
Like is it like a crossover app? Yeah, iPhone and iPad apps from the same download and purchase. So you can get into that too.
That's my jam. I've been drawing on it all week. You know what I'm saying?
So, and there's a little bit of the iPad.
Oh, yeah, that was my drawing.
Is this nice flower here? There you go.
No.
There you go.
Oh, yeah,
it's a bat.
Everything but the one I'm trying to.
I think it's a bat.
Everything but the one that's actually mine.
Yeah. Awesome. So check that out, Sketchpad. It's on everything, apparently. It's on Google, Android as well. iOS, Mac OS, and looks like Windows as well.
Sketchbook, dude.
What's that?
Sketchbook.
What did I say?
Pad. Why did you say
Sketchpad?
Pad? This is not
Sketchbook Pro.
What?
Sketchbook Pro.
What?
I'm going to drink some more coffee.
You should have put some chocolate in there. Get some mocha, though.
Well, no. We've been dropping some pumpkin syrup that Katie gave me.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say anything. You see my complexion, and that's all I have to say.
It's a list.
Why do you keep going back to Kate?
Because it's the button in the middle, and I'm not good with the transitions tonight.
Somebody's blowing up the phone.
She's always
like, oh, look.
It's Giving Tuesday.
It is.
She has customer support she needs to be dealing
what
with.
What are
right
you giving? You got some pumpkin in your tea right there?
No, it's a peppermint.
Peppermint with some pumpkin syrup?
Peppermint pumpkin.
I love some peppermint tea. Oh, so good. We have mint in the front of our yard, so I'll just grab some of it and throw it into some hot water and then put some ice in it and have some cool, when it was warm out. It's hot now. You want hot tea, so that's why. Yeah, I'm saying.
So my awesome thing. Oh, but speaking of which, I'm about to talk about video games.
You got video games on your awesome.
And we gotta check on the kids in the back.
Kids. What is he doing?
The goat is on fire.
And the other one's being sacrificed.
The other one's at a sacrifice at the pentagram.
What the hell?
The goat simulator's going on.
What is this person?
The kids
dancing?
Are back there. Yeah, but this is the
he's taking him away.
The Sorgatron Media babysitting system here, and yeah, they're playing some Goat Simulator in the back here. So I need to update. This.
They love this game.
Yeah, they
but
do.
What is he doing in the pentagram?
I only see one of them. Oh, there's both of them in the camera now.
Is he even doing? No, he's just standing there.
He's just standing there. I think they're just maybe he went over to play Pac-Man. I set up the Pac-Man arcade.
I think maybe he's just doing a seance.
I think you need to have a talk with your kid.
As long as the lights aren't going to go off.
You're like, listen, I know that goat was in there for a while. And let's talk about what this means and why you should be wearing or whatever. Anyways, no, what I've been playing is, and this is a game that I've made, I've been aware of it because these games have been sitting on my Game Pass list for years at this point, right, on Xbox. And they just came out with a new one. It is the longest title ever. It is Like a Dragon Gaiden, The Man Who Erased His Name. And this is part of the Yakuza series. They've been rebranding it and everything. It became aware to me because they did a... Oh, there's some music again.
Oh, yeah, play
there
it.
Is a... No, I don't want to get to... We're already pushing the YouTube boundaries here. They did a match on AEW a few weeks ago that was sponsored by this, and they dressed up like the characters and everything like that. And then turns out, as I'm researching this, by the way, I played this game in a week and beat it. It's kind of a short side story, but it was a lot of fun. So basically, this is a beat 'em up game with a lot of story, and also a lot of Japanese subtitles. So you're gonna do a lot of reading over your 13 hours of playing this game. Also, it duped me because it was about 1 a.m. and I was like, hey, take this last save. You're going to go to the boss stuff. I'm like, okay, I think I'm good. I can do the end of this game before I go to bed, right? 4 hours later, I finished the game. So they kind of duped me for that. They got some really cool spy weapons. Like, the whole thing is like you pick things up and smash people with it. It's just
like some Mike Takashi shit.
It is some cool shit. It's some cool Japanese like kung fu shit and storytelling here. It's a crime family thing. It is
the Yakuza.
Over the top. It is so much fun, and now I want to go back and play some. I went from this and started playing Yakuza Zero because again, like, just about every one of the Yakuza games are on Xbox Game Pass, so you can jump through those. And this is a series that started actually on the PlayStation 2. And the first two games from the PlayStation, one, everything's been remastered since. 3, 4, and 5 have been remastered for the Xbox One and Series, I guess. And they started bringing all of their early games to Xbox a little more recent years, like over the last 5 years. The first two games from the PlayStation, because you're like, a PlayStation 2 game, that sounds like that's going to be rough. Believe me, I tried playing Grand Theft Auto 4 last night. That game does not hold up well technically. Okay. It's like, oh, why is everybody's hand still square?
I'm still playing 3.
I know, right? Yeah. Like, that's the charm of it, right? but it's just so much fun and goofy in the right places. One of the side missions is where the fun happens, right? Because it's so serious for the main story. One side mission was I need to meet up with a rapper who loves cats, and I have to round up all the cats that are being bullied by the thugs in the neighborhood so that he'll join my fight team.
So the rapper or
the
cat?
Rapper.
Or the
so
cats.
The rapper will join my cage fighting team.
Nice.
Because I'm recruiting people. I also recruited the world's strongest convenience store clerk.
How many kittens did you have to save?
Like 4 or 5.
What?
But then there was a wrestling angle where I ran into a luchador in Japan.
I thought you were going to say Kurt because you said
and angle. I had to pass out flyers for his show so he could join my cage fighting.
Nice.
Group. So then I start researching on this game. Turns out in Yakuza 6, and this is a crossover. I'm sorry for the wrestling side. They have about 12 different wrestlers from New Japan Pro Wrestling.
Wow.
Including, some people will be excited about this, Yano. I am going to bring this up on the Mayhem Show, probably for the Patreon later today. So, check it out. If you're on Game Pass, Like a Dragon Gaiden, Man Who Erased His Name, is a day and date release. It was released like 2 weeks ago, and you can play it. I played through it. Holy crap. I put aside Gotham Knights and Assassin's Creed for this. So it's been good. It's been a lot of fun. So highly recommend it. It's on, I think everything's on the PlayStation as well. I think this was a PlayStation exclusive series for a while. So you definitely have those over there too.
And I see
Steam was just had on sale a big bundle of all the games for PC. If that's what you're on to, I don't know if they're on maybe Switch or anything like that yet, but I don't see why not.
Because look at the graphics. It's not going to look like that on no Switch.
The graphics
aren't
that crazy, though. Well, that's what they're really not that crazy.
Did you see Mortal Kombat's port to Switch,
though?
Oh,
my God. Don't
did you see that, though?
Yo, listen, Mortal Kombat 1 has been glitching on me. I knocked somebody. Somebody went invisible. I knocked their head off with brutality, and then it just hung there.
Wow.
I keep losing all sound in the middle of fights.
Nice.
And I'm on the Xbox Series X or S, so I'm just like, well, it's not because I have the older one, because, you know, like Fall Guys is glitchy as hell on an Xbox One, right?
And I got I didn't know that because I don't mess with
it. Stuff like that, you know, takes forever to load and doesn't work. Doesn't even load, right? Crashes out half the time these days, right?
Yeah.
So anyways.
I mean, I like the Switch, yeah.
So absolutely. Though. Absolutely. It's a, yeah, So check out Yakuza games. You like a dragon, and if fighting games aren't your thing, the Like a Dragon, what was the one?
Side games would be perfect for you if you don't like
Yakuza
fighting.
Like a Dragon from a few years ago is actually a turn-based RPG.
Oh, was it
in this universe? And it crosses over with the game they just.
That universe reminds me of Old Boy, that Korean revenge movie.
Okay, yeah, it is kind of some of that.
Yeah.
A lot of that, not as revenge-y, and plus they have a throwback from like Japan in the 1800s that looks interesting too.
1800s.
Yeah. So Yakuza, Like a Dragon, look any of those up. You'll find a bunch of games. There's something like 18 releases since like 2005 for the series, and I barely know about it, and it's Sega. So.
Sega got some jams though, for real, for real. Mm-hmm. Like, you gotta, like, give it up for Sega for just being like, all right, we just gonna play the background. We're gonna make these games. I have not seen a game that's not, like, dude, Sega be, they be killing
it. They're very Japanese games.
Yeah.
Oh, and there's arcades in this game, so you can go and play, like, Fighting Vipers. Yo! I was playing Sonic Fighters in this game. I love this stuff. Street Fighter 6 does the same thing where you can play old
yeah,
Street
yeah,
Fighters.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Sega kills it.
On the video game side, if you're on the PC, have something that can play video games on the PC. This is not a newer one, so it'll probably play on most of your systems out there. Assassin's Creed Syndicate is now free. It's not with Stream Deck would count too. Assassin's Creed Syndicate is now free for PC until December 6th. Highly recommend this. This is the last of the like classic Assassin's Creed games. Before they went way too big. This is in like Steam Engine era London. And
hold
like,
up, that's Ubisoft too, because Ubisoft be making some decent stuff too, for real.
Some good high-end stuff. So if you're like something like Odyssey and Origin that takes 60 hours to complete is too much for you, this is where you should go. Sick. Check it up. It's free to keep. You got to log into the Ubisoft.com account, and you can add it to your library from there.
You call it Ubisoft?
I think I said it wrong. I don't even know if we're saying it right. I don't know. It's French or something. So
is it French?
Yeah, I think most of the good games
Ubisoft.
Are from, most of the good games are from Ubisoft Montreal. Yeah. But I think the parent company is from France.
Yeah, they always eat croissants there.
Yes, yes.
Croissant at Ubisoft.
So go check that out. Katie, have you seen this story about the iPhone that's been hitting the local news lately? Going around.
I can't put it near any other iPhone because
no,
it
don't let your eye
info.
Turn this off. Katie, explain what's going on here. What I just preventively have sent my mother and told the Missy to hit the in-laws and just be like to let them know to not worry about the iPhone news going on right now. Have you been picking up on this?
Yes. So I'm looking at your article. So in iOS 17, there's the name drop feature, and with the name drop, it's similar to when we used to bump our phones, and we would exchange information that way. They're saying I don't have another phone to even be like that up.
I'm looking for the one around. I'm like, oh, these are like iPhone 16s and stuff.
iOS 16. Google Pixel. So
you
got a
Google
care.
Over there. But there's a very
you
cool thing where
it.
You like when you AirDrop, like it'll wave your phone, and the AirDrop thing will happen when you make contact with a phone. Just go bump up. Katie and I were doing this on the last trip a bit. So, but it's a really cool effect and it's very handy, right? But I guess like contact sharing is part of that, right?
Yes. So So people are saying like if your phone's in a different locker but near another iPhone, you should be worried about it, and like all of these things. So the problem is everybody's freaking out because they're like, I got to turn this off so I don't share like certain information with somebody else, or someone could take my information. But you have to accept the share,
mm-hmm.
or you have to So you have to initiate the share. Yes, the user must press the share button for the information transfer to happen. And then you have to, then they'll agree to it. I'm trying to remember what happened when we did it. you know, what was the...
I think there was a prompt that came up. As, you know, you would bump. It would do the thing, a pop-up. Do you want to receive a share? I hit the check mark and it goes.
Hell no, I don't
want
to share.
Like, I don't know if there's like by default, I don't think there's a accept everything. And generally security, I think accept everything would be a problem, right?
Yeah, and because I think it was a thing where you could change it. I'm going to look now. For the that it be, you know, like folks who are, you know, friends, contacts, versus like the every, you know, the everybody thing, like when you get an airdrop. Mm-hmm. Now I'm looking at name drop.
So just this is just a little bit of a PSA. Just if you see us on the news, if your, you know, relatives are like, you know, asking you about tech things or something like that, you have an iPhone and you're worried about this, and because there, you know, I've been seeing the headlines, I've been seeing the scary stuff popping up everywhere about this, so it just seems like one of those just way overblown kind of things, so like just be wary of that. You know, this is I made a post about, like, you know, sometimes you don't realize how fear-mongering a lot of this stuff is until you know it's something you actually know about, right? So like, and that's from like the local news. It's not like the cable news, whatever kerfuffle is going on there. This is just the local news stuff. And it just kind of illustrates that point a little bit more if you haven't seen that. So
that's been everywhere.
Yeah, it has been. And it was supposed, well, this is where it started. It was a police advisory from Middleton, Ohio, which I think is outside of Dayton. So it hit the Dayton news and then just kind of blew up from there to the point where, like, I heard about this 24 hours ago and it's been everywhere since, right? Like, then it's on the local news. I think PXI was something I shared earlier today with it, right? So just watch out for it. You know, it's just one of those weird things that happens. So I just it's just going to be some bad information and scary things out there. So, but you know, technology is to blame for everything. So I ended up playing nothing but Ghost Simulator back there. It's great. So. YouTube is getting into games. That seems like an open statement. Playable games. So Netflix, by the way, I loaded Netflix on my Chromecast Google TV last night, right? And in the preview was not a trailer for the hottest new Netflix movie. I can't remember what else is coming up on that this month on Netflix. But anyways, something with Adam Sandler as a lizard. I don't know. But there was a preview for an app game for Netflix in the TV app. So it's fun that is now kind of creeping in and they're telling the more broad people that aren't using the apps on the phones that there's games. A lot of people still don't know there's games on Netflix, by the way. So, but yeah, if you go in there in the game section, you can find the games on your Android or iOS device and play them for free. Some cool stuff. The Ninja Turtle Shredder Revenge game is in there. You know, other things.
Two like hot that. Games.
What's that?
The sexy games where you're
there's so many
flirty
weird,
games.
So many strange dating games in there. It's so strange. Hey, it's just like, why is this your corner here? Like, it just, there's a good Tomb Raider mobile game on there actually that I've been playing. So if you want to get into that, there's there's Storyteller, Farming Simulator 23, Love is Blind, Too Hot to Handle 2. Too Hot to Handle 1. A soccer game. Oh, I'm sorry, football. Yeah, it's very strange. But then they'll have like games that have been pretty decent, like 12 Minutes we talked about on the show. World of Goo is a good classic game. Exploding Kittens, the game. A Transformers fighting game. A lot of Stranger Things. So, again, worth exploring. Anyways, YouTube is doing something similar, it seems, as well. So they're actually making a... They're calling this on the verge, a modest push into the world of games with a rollout of more than 30 mini games. So the idea is that they'll pop these in here and these will actually work in browser on the desktop. Things like billiards, Angry Birds, you know, a lot of kind of like, you know, simple games, right? So it's a curious play for them, but why not? I guess, like, it seems like an extension of, you could already play a lot of these games if you go to like Chrome and the extensions. There's a lot of these games in there. Like, I know Angry Birds was something I could play just in my browser previously, right? Or if you had like a Chrome OS device, a Chromebook or something like that too. So I don't know, it's like, it seems like everybody's KD is making this run to integrate games into their services.
Yeah, I like it.
You like it. And then you don't.
I like to see.
Good.
Just the sheer randomness, I think it. Like the ways they kind of do something similar to something else, and you're like, wait, and it's just different. I like it.
Sometimes,
I like it.
Sometimes it seems so scattered, though, right?
Yeah.
So, Kid Mental, what do you think of games starting to integrate into YouTube?
I don't even mess with YouTube as much as I used to, so I don't even care. It's just gonna be another excuse for me to have to do parental codes on my kids' phones for crap that they're doing. So great, thanks YouTube for adding another thing that I gotta watch out for. I mean, we already got it on Alexa, like the Prime TV or whatever, you can play games on the remote control. So it's like, thanks, YouTube.
I haven't seen that any of these are freemium games necessarily, but you know, I mean, they are ad supported on YouTube. So there's probably just a lot of ads around your Angry Birds or something like that, right? So
you think? Yeah, I mean, everything revolves around ads.
Yeah, that's the way it goes. It's the way it goes with those. I pay for premium, so I don't do the ads.
I mean, you got it's a Google. YouTube's your Google, so like you got Google Play. Like, what is like?
Yep.
Okay, so maybe they're just seeing a shift because of the Chromebooks and everything. All the kids got the Chromes and everything. I don't know.
So we'll see how that develops there. But yeah, I don't know. It seemed like an interesting pivot since they got rid of like all the Stadia stuff that was supposed to play like real games, like your Assassin's Creed and stuff like that in your browser. So
I don't know. They're killing a lot. Like I can't even. They're killing podcasts. Google podcasts.
Yeah, I think they're integrating it into music, which is starting to make music confusing. By the way,
it's so annoying. Mm-hmm. They already couldn't keep my wherever the save pin. I was trying to go back to listen to something and everything's gone and now they're just getting rid of it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks. Appreciate
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Google.
Yeah.
Thanks, Google. Canceling something
Love
else.
It. Yeah.
IKEA is in my smart home news on The Verge. This is kind of interesting because and I wish Chilla was here because he would be able to talk about some proper. I think he's talked about these before because we know Chilla has like the house of the future with all of his automated devices. IKEA is debuting affordable smart home sensors. So the idea is this is something that you're going to put motion sensors in your home or maybe just like door open sensors. And this kind of leans into the if this and that thing that we talked about earlier, right? Where, you know, hey, somebody open the front door, make sure the fridge is doing this and this smart thing's doing this. And I send a text to, you know, let me know that my wife's home or something, right? So that's the idea, you know, or even
that's not the idea. They're trying to catch people cheating. That's
or
what it is.
Yeah, okay. There's that.
That's all this whole thing.
Or there's like for instance, like here, like yo, did your kid get out of bed in the middle of the night? There's a sensor, you know, you could put in the
you're gonna
hallway
remove
doorway.
The mystery of them
mystery
haunting,
of the kids
haunting yo, you in the middle of the night,
or just making sure nobody breaks in your windows and opens your doors and everything like that. Replace it, you know, have your own de facto. Security kit or something like that
for $10 a piece.
For $10, that's more than that's not bad.
I mean, yeah,
that's not bad.
That's not and it's not bad, but
if they work, that's great.
If they work,
that's right. You get one. See how they work. See how reliable it is. If it works, it's like the Wyze Cam. The Wyze Cams were like $30. I was like, oh man, these really kind of work, and I bought like six of them. So for everything, I still need to buy more.
Yeah.
You know, for all the nooks and crannies of home and the office. So, yeah, no, I think that's the idea of that, and that's something that I think it's a nice – so this is actually – I'm sorry, it's $9.99 in Europe. The exact U.S. pricing is yet to be confirmed on the sensors. So
if that's a euro,
that's right.
Then it's going to be more than that.
So it's going to be like $12 maybe.
Probably.
If they go along that. Yeah. Maybe it'll be $10 here or $15, something like that. So
it's going to be
But still,
$15.
That's pretty affordable to say, okay, I'm going to grab a couple of those, throw in these couple – important doorways.
What would you use yours for? Really? Like what would you, if you got one or somebody gave it to you, what would you do?
What would I do?
Yes.
Well, I already technically have motion sensor with the cameras. So I want it. So you would motion sensor something that you didn't want a camera on. Right?
I mean,
like the hallway or, you know, okay, did the dog break through and, you know, the gate and he went upstairs while I was away or something like that. And you have a motion sensor to let you know, like you can do an if this then that and say if I'm not home, because we connected to something that
if my dog breaks through play a song.
Yes.
Break on through to the other side. Then
tell my Amazon Echo upstairs to yell at the dog to go back downstairs.
Yeah,
you know, like something like that. Like
you ever program your Alexa so that it talks to the dog because it knows the dialect?
I haven't done that. No. There's definitely a guard dog mode that I put on where it barks when it hears something.
Yeah.
And I ask it to play music for my dog when I leave.
Oh,
it's like classical music.
That's nice. So,
It's supposed to be good for the dog to calm them down. So, you know.
Maybe you could do an if then that where you have a couple of sensors and the dog will start to learn each sensor, and one would be Bach, and then the other one would be Mozart, and then the other one might be Cherkov.
My dog's 13 years old. It might be a little late to be
never know
teaching that
too. Just put the three different ones there. Yeah, you know I'm saying, and see what happens when you come home.
Katie, you have a lot of cats. I know you're dealing with. Is there anything you'd be using the sensors for to make sure that they're not getting into something?
I don't know. They wouldn't. It wouldn't matter. They would just go where they want anyway.
there's no stopping them.
They're cats. Like,
I've relegated that. There's no stopping them at all. So, yeah. So we'll keep an eye on that. That might be a good thing to look out for. And, you know, maybe when they're on sale, grab them, you know, and they will be dropping in the U.S.
So these are coming
in January. They're going to be in the U.S.
They're going
to
be in Aldi, yeah. Right? That's what you said?
IKEA.
Same difference.
Great if Aldi's had them, too.
They probably will.
So you can pick those up when you're picking up the sweet full pajama set like Katie has.
Yeah.
Yes.
They got those strawberry, those chocolate covered strawberry filling. Those things are so good.
Yes.
So addicted to them.
Anyways, what happened there? I think I bumped my camera. Yep. All right.
See,
that's why I said I got to reset everything up because there's a bad cord in here somewhere. There I am.
Oh, no. You butted out the camera.
Yeah, exactly. Oh my gosh. Well, I think that is all
you gotta play
that
news,
we have
the news
for.
Job.
Oh, I did the
you
thing.
Said
I did the thing. Yep, it's the news. That was the news. Yep, there it is.
Yay.
And this has been your. This is the AwesomeCast. And thank you to our guest dropping in here, having some fun with us tonight. There you go. See, I'm getting the hang of it, right? Yeah. I'm getting the hang of
no,
it.
No, you're not.
No. I got a long way
slowly,
to go.
Slowly, you'll get there.
Slowly, I'm getting there.
One day.
Listen, when all the technology works tonight, because we had some down services, we had some issues with the stream, but, you know, it's going to happen every once
in
a while.
Good. You
get it out
good.
Of my system so it doesn't help for the professional stuff this weekend, right? What do you mean we didn't check the audio? Okay. But anyways, we had a different show this. Actually, I'll give a shout out to our friends at Top Rope Tabletop Pro Wrestlers playing Dungeons and Dragons over on the indiewrestling.us YouTube page. If you want to go watch that back, a lot of fun. Our crew in here for that. That's why I think a couple of things were out of sorts because I didn't double check them because I'm trying to do some new things. Also, so one thing I did do. We are trying to stream some new places. So, hopefully as long as this experiment lasts, we've been trying to stream to Instagram. If, some of you are listening out over there, hello, welcome. And, I hope you guys, check it out again. Please subscribe to the show. This is a podcast. So it means we're on podcast providers. So go check out the AwesomeCast. Kid Mental is what's your website?
Kidmental.com, KIDMENTAL. Changing stuff, so don't ask me.
He's in that process. He's in that process right now. So, but go see what's going on. It's got some cool stuff. Interesting projects we've been talking about, you know. You never know what's gonna happen here. So making some connections, see what generates for 2024 here. All
yes.
Right. Like there's some energy. There's some energy
there's some
happening
energy.
Here.
Some positive energy.
Positive energy.
Some additive energy.
I need it for days like this. So yeah, exactly. That's why we do the podcast. This is my therapy for the week is doing these things, especially later when I swear at the Wrestling Mayhem Show. So also thank you once again to. It's Katie. Oh God! No! Hit everything! Oh no! It's going sideways!
Oh, what is that?
It's
what
going
happened?
Sideways.
That's sweet.
Kate Murray BGH on social medias. The important ones.
Find it all. Yep.
Toilet Tuesday has returned. I see on Threads.
Yeah, I missed that.
Somebody took a picture, and I was like, my sister was talking about a picture of a porta potty from something she came across. I'm like, no, yes, send that to Katie. Yes.
What is Toilet Tuesdays?
So, you know what? I'm going to talk about Toilet Tuesday and why there's a Toilet Tuesday with Kid Mental on the Patreon. Ooh. I'm at Sorgatron on, that's a tease. I'm at Sorgatron on all the social medias as well, and I'm doing the best I can, guys. So we'll see you guys next week. You have been our awesome audience. Have an awesome week. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at Sorgatron.